Hi everyone, I'm Cody Holyoke at the National Frontier Trails Museum in Independence on Pacific Ave, just south of the square, along with Lindsay Robbins, who's been nice enough to show us around today. There's so much history here, and it all starts with those three trails.
Yes, we're really fortunate here in Missouri, and especially Independence, to have a rich history. And when it comes to the trails, we've got some of the best.
That's right. Well, we all know about Santa Caligon because of the festival, but tell us a little bit about the trails.
So Santa Caligon gets its name from Santa, California, and Oregon trails. And so they all started here in Independence. You can see on our map, the star highlights Independence. We were the end of the frontier for most of the United States for a long time. So everyone had to travel through to Missouri, basically, to head out on those trails. And so people would go for several different reasons. Santa Fe was usually to make money through trade. Oregon, lots of times, you know, there's a lot of land out in Oregon, so people would take advantage of that. And the California Gold Rush played a huge role in why people went to California.
I was going to say, I bet gold was a motivating
factor. Money's
there.
A pretty big motivator.
Nice, yeah, I imagine. And so this is a really neat setup that you have. You kind of wind your way through here and learn a little bit about the history.
Yes,
right?
So our tours are self-guided, so you can take as much time as you like. And then you can focus on what you like as well. And a lot of people like to stop in here and learn a little bit more about what life was like for merchants in Independence.
Old general store.
Yep, you can see a general store and a blacksmith setup.
Wow. And so these are all relics, artifacts that you guys have found through your research?
Yes, so it's a combination of reproductions, which are authentic remade objects, and then original artifacts as well.
Okay, and then of course it wouldn't be a museum talking about westward expansion without mentioning the wagons.
That's right. You can imagine that transportation was one of the most important objects with the trail. So what people don't often realize is the wagons were used to carry supplies, and individuals typically walked alongside those wagons.
Okay, yeah, we think a lot about with the video game Oregon Trail and people going, about people going west, but not a lot about the
cargo. You don't think about those goods. No. And then what's really interesting is you can learn more about people and their individual stories if you visit our research library. We have a lot of personal firsthand accounts there.
Nice. And so you do have to get an appointment for that, though,
yes,
right?
That's appointment required there.
Nice. But what sort of things do we find? Because it's not just books that you've written about westward expansion. You can find actual handwriting,
yes,
right?
Yes, letters, diaries, business invoices, a whole lot of variety in all age groups and genders as well. We have young boys, age of 15, writing diaries, young girls, and then we have women, men, so a huge variety. You can learn a lot.
Mm-hmm. Just a treasure trove of info right in our backyard. Okay, so if I'm a family and just want to visit the museum part of it, what do we need to know?
So you can visit our website to learn more. We're open 7 days a week, and just give us a call if you'd like to know anything else.
All right, so that's the City of Independence's website, right?
Yes.
Perfect. So for more information, head that way. In Independence, I'm Cody Holyoke, KMBC 9 News.